If you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel. And this is my channel name, Dr. Javed Iqbal Kokhar, Lectures on Forensic Medicine. Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Javed Iqbal Kokhar, Professor of Forensic Medicine and Toxicology. In this video lecture, I will be discussing about the bore, gauge, and caliber of firearm. And the learning objective of this lecture will be, we'll learn what is meant by bore, bore of smoothbore weapon, and how they are applied in rifled and smoothbore weapons. Bore is a little complicated term. It does not refer to the diameter of the barrel, but actually some gas pressures and other calculating things, they are also referred. As the bore number increases, the barrel diameter decreases. Bore are available in numbers 10, 12, 16, 20, 24, and 410. Respectively, 10 being the largest and the 410 being the smallest. Generally speaking, the caliber and the bore are almost same. The only difference is of language. Caliber is used in modern countries and others use the word bore for the caliber. For practical purposes, they are the same when using these terms in day-to-day life. Actually, they are two different diameters inside a barrel. But for officially, both having different things. Cartridges are named in different ways. Some for the bore, some for the caliber of the bullet, and some are not following the both. Now starting the detailed discussion on the bore. Bore is the inside diameter of any cylinder such as gun barrel. Bore in weaponry is the interior of the barrel of a gun or a firearm. They may have rifled barrels, for example, the rifles, pistols, and machine guns. This is a picture showing the external height, the internal height, and the external width and the internal width, and the bore height. The smoothbore weapons, typically the shotguns, have no rifling, whereas most of the handguns and rifles, they have the rifling. This is a picture showing the smoothbore and the rifled. You can see the rifling, that is the spirally twisted grooves which run parallel to each other from chamber to muzzle end. So the barrel may be smoothbore, which means that the barrel is without rifling. They can be varied from handguns to powerful tank guns and large artillery. They are all smoothbore. The smoothbore have barrels with interior that are perfectly smooth. And the smooth surface allows the projectile to move quickly down the length of the barrel. they are well suited for firing multiple projectiles at the same time. Now, how we calculate bore in smoothbore weapons? The diameter is usually the bore, and the formula which applies, D for diameter square divided by 4 and multiplied by pi. It means diameter or bore times itself, that means multiplied by itself, divided by 4 and multiplied by pi. Now there are also gauges which are available, which having the dial bore gauges. This is a picture of the gauge. And there is the gauge is inserted into the cylinder with head straight up across the cylinder. We lower it into the opening until it is sitting about 1/2 to 1 inch below the rim. And then the gauge determines the bore. Then how we calculate bore in rifled weapons? In rifled weapons, most of the barrels having rifling, that means they have lands and grooves. In cross section of a gun barrel, there is a circle with a gear touching edge. The metal is on the outer side of this shape, not inside it. This is the raised margin, which is the lands, and the depressed are the grooves. So if you draw circles, one circle will be touching the tops of the lands like this. And an outer circle touching the bottoms of the grooves like this. So the diameter of the inner smaller circle, which is on the top of the lands, is the bore diameter. And the largest round thing which could pass through the barrel is the circle which is touching the grooves. That means this is the maximum size which can pass through. This represents the much larger things which can pass through the barrel, and by passing through will be cut or pressed into by the lands of the barrel. These are the lands or the raised edges of the rifled bore, and they will mark. By passing through the cut or the pressed marks by the lands of the barrel will give impressions, and they help in identifying the weapon also. Then other effects of the rifling, you can see that it gives the spin, the gyroscopic spin to the bullet, and that is help, that helps in the accuracy, overcome the resistance of the air. Whereas in the smoothbore weapon, there is no rifling, there is no spin, and the projectile wobble after emitting from the weapon. Thank you very much. This is all about the bore, and in the next lecture, we'll be discussing the gauge and the caliber. Allah Hafiz. Take care. Bye-bye.